up, everybody? It's your girl Sofia, aka Sophie, back here on Sophia's Football Talk to do a short but sweet match preview, as I'm not able to do a live, not completely fit today, but hey, still was able to film this video for you guys regardless, which is of course for the upcoming match against FC Copenhagen in the Champions League at Old Trafford. A must-win game, 100%. There is no excuses. If we do not win this game, yeah, at that point, you kind of have to say the Champions League hopes are for sure done. And that would be very unfortunate because I still want to be able to hear the champions. I don't want to hear, if we do get, you know, knocked out of the Champions League. Let's just say that by the end of it, that mathematically, it ain't possible no more. Then me personally, I'd rather than just finish bottom of the group and then just exit and not get into the Europa League, because I don't know, it's just, not to disrespect the Europa League competition, but there's one thing if you're all already, you know, let's say you finish sixth or fifth in your league, and then by the beginning of the season you already start in the Europa League, that's different. But if you, you know, are in the Champions League and then you get knocked out and get straight into the what should I say, qualification and all that in the Europa League, then that for me is not ideal. That's definitely not what I want to happen, but I'm gonna hope and believe that we're gonna win tomorrow. Of course, we'll see. When it comes to team news, though, we got Reguilón back. He'll probably be available. I wonder if not he'll start, but I'll give my prediction of the starting 11 a little bit later in the video. Evans, I believe, is also injured. No info on return date. Casemiro, obviously, we knew already prior that he wouldn't be available to, you know, play for tomorrow's game, as he's suspended due to the second yellow card he got in the Galatasaray game. And either way, he also does still have that knock from the international break, so We'll probably see him more for the Manchester Derby on Sunday, but right now we won't be seeing him for tomorrow's game. When it comes to FC Copenhagen, I want to also mention a little bit of their team list, because of course this is Rasmus Højlund's former team. I mean, FC Copenhagen is a Danish team, used to play for Copenhagen before. He also has two of his brothers, which are twin brothers, do play for Copenhagen, so he could be reunited with one of his brothers, Oscar, who has played two Champions League qualifiers and was introduced as a late substitute during the 2-2 draw with Galatasaray on match day one. While his twin brother, Emil, isn't in the first team squad, but has started and scored in both youth league fixtures for the Danes too far and should be involved at Lee on Tuesday. So, yeah, it'll be interesting to see. I mean, we also do, of course, have two players that I'm definitely very much so familiar with in Mohamed Elneny, who used to, of course, play for Southampton, went, I believe, as a free agent now for FC Copenhagen, plays for them. He also has been, you know, and throughout the years, an important player for Norway's men's team, has missed the last two, three so international breaks, or maybe two, I would say, this fall. So he has not really been, you know, called up, but still a very good player, the midfielder. We also have Birgin Meling, the fullback. For him, though, unfortunately, he did sustain an injury, a knock, I believe, in last game for Copenhagen. So he will not be available for tomorrow's game. But definitely, the player that I'll be like, okay, you might need to look at a little bit with Mohamed Elneny. Of course, Copenhagen, you know, they played their first Champions League game against Galatasaray, which ended in 2-2. They started off very strong, but then Galatasaray came back and finished, of course, with a draw. And then they, I believe, lost 2-1 to Bayern in the second game. So now for the third game, which, of course, I hope Man United can do and win. The most important team now is thinking, okay, how will we be setting up the team? I think we do need to make some changes. And I don't know exactly if Ten Hag is going to do this, but this is just what I'm assuming is what he's going to do. So we have Onana in goal. We have, as I believe, Reguilón will be starting. He'll be the left back. We have Dalot as the right back. I have a feeling as McGuire has played well, he probably will be starting. I do not want to see him start for the Manchester Derby, if I'm going to be honest, but he'll probably start this game. And then we'll see Varane back as well as his partner in the midfield, as Casemiro, of course, like I said, not available. Scott McTominay did play, but, you know, yeah, he scored. He also did give the opposition team a penalty, and also he was kind of hiding in that midfield as well. So for me, I felt like a midfield with an Amrabat and Eriksen really add more balance. I mean, we controlled way more in the second half against Sheffield United when Eriksen came on in that particular game. So Mason Mount obviously came in a few minutes as a sub. I would presume and predict that he probably will be starting. Bruno, I don't want to see him on the wing, but I just think regardless, then I probably will try to shoehorn him in. But in my personal opinion, I do think he should be dropped. I'm just thinking he probably wouldn't do it, which at some point though, Ten Hag probably might have to die on that sword, die on that hill, if he continues to not be brave, which we know he can be, but I don't know. I think Bruno needs to sit this way, one out, but he probably won't. But we'll see. Rashi looked tight. He looked better than he's done in some of the other games against Sheffield United. Just, of course, the finishing. But overall, I thought he had an all right game. So I think he probably will be starting. And then Højlund, obviously, been scoring 3 goals so far in the Champions League. He probably will be adding more. It'll be exciting for him to watch, you know, play against one of his brothers, younger brothers. So it'll be definitely very interesting. But this is what I'm predicting for sure. But then, what will my score prediction be? I often feel like throughout the season, I've often been predicting a 2-1 win. And that's probably going to be the case. I have to predict that my team will win. The most important thing, just get a win. That's all. I don't want to see a draw. Win the game. We're at home. We're obviously as well in the next Champions League game, which I think will be in 2 weeks or so from now. We're going to then be playing Copenhagen again, but at their ground. So it's important that we do win the remaining games that we have left. Okay. Which will be, of course, very difficult, may I add, but we have to. 100% we have to. So that's what I'm thinking for tomorrow's game. I want to, of course, hear your points as well. What are your thoughts? Who do you think will be starting? Do you want to see start? And what's your score prediction? Make sure that you, of course, let me know down below in the comment section. Give this video here a big thumbs up. And we'll subscribe to the channel. We are on the road to 3K subscribers. So let's make that happen. I'll be back most likely and hopefully tomorrow for the match reaction after the game alongside some other games that we'll talk about. So other than that, have a great time. See y'all soon. Peace. Bye-bye.